The model of the cold welder we use for welding today is HSAPS03. This cold welder can instantly release the electric energy stored in the capacitor through a pulsed arc and release a very high temperature arc between the black hole and the metal to be welded. It makes the metal material and the welding wire quickly melt to form a solder joint to achieve the purpose of welding or repair. The characteristics of welding are also more prominent. It can form the purpose of repairing in a very short time when the heat is small. This type of welding can complete the welding process of the welding wire and the object in tens of seconds. Compared with its ordinary welding machine, more than a few seconds, the heat conducted to the metal is very small. In other words, the body of the metal object generates less heat, and the material temperature of the solder joint is unexpectedly low, and there will be no annealing or discoloration, since the volume of the molten pool generated by each welding pulse is also less than 20 mm. The stress formed by it is relatively small. Although a welding repair requires more molten pools to be combined, the stress direction of the solder joints is dispersed, so the metal objects are exposed to less concentrated stress, less deformation of metal objects after welding. This type of welding has the following advantages. 1. High welding strength. Metallurgical welding can be completed, and the repaired part can be polished, milled, filed, polished and other post-processing treatments. 2. The repairing accuracy is very high. Round wire can be used for repairing without losing the original datum plane. There is less excess solder, and the later shaping is easier. Its minimum repair amount is 0.05 mm. Use a repair material with a diameter of 0.15 mm. 3. The newly added group welding and wire feeding function can better adapt to metal objects with complex shapes and speed up their repair time. The repair speed is very fast, and the fastest repair amount can reach 100 mm/s. 5. The damage of the substrate is small, and it will not cause annealing or deformation of the material. 6. The distribution of power is very reasonable. Using microcomputer chip to control various materials with different diameters will get the best power. 8. The wire-controlled automatic dimming mask provides greater shielding of the radiation generated by the arc, and the built-in LED strong light lamp can provide a better operating vision. The electrical connection is also more convenient. It is equipped with a quick connector for easy connection and installation. The materials that can be welded and repaired by this machine can be welded and repaired in addition to materials with low melting points such as zinc and tin and hard alloys, as well as various metal materials including copper and aluminum. There are three items that can be welded. The first item is the local wear of equipment and abrasive tools during use. The second item is processing defects in the manufacturing process, such as blisters, pores, very poor sizes, damage to edges and corners, and insufficient argon. The third item is the depression of the rusty spot of the cavity. The power supply is single phase 220V50HZ, and the power consumption is 10 to 1200W. The maximum power output at a moment is greater than 40 kW. Argon arc output is divided into modes, mode 1, mode 2, mode 3, and mode 4. The output pulse current can be adjusted from 1-99, and the output pulse time can also be adjusted from 1-99. The output of the solder mask is divided into single point or continuous electricity, and the size of the welding wire can be adjusted from 0.1 mm to 1 mm. The pulse frequency during continuous output can be divided into four gears. They are 1 Hz, 2 Hz, 3 Hz, 5 Hz. There are 12 functional operations on the front of the machine. The first is mode selection. 20. Pulse current display. The third is the pulse time adjustment. The fourth is to adjust the group welding. The fifth is single point or continuous mode welding. The sixth is to control the switch. The seventh is the ground wire. The eighth is the display of pulse time. The ninth is the adjustment of pulse time. The tenth is to start and pause. The 11th is the output of solder mask. The 12th is the output of arc welding. The back part of the machine is divided into five parts. The first is the argon excuse. The second is the power switch. The third is the cooling fan. The fourth is the shading cap interface. The fifth is the power input. During welding, there are strong arc flashes and high temperature spatters that can burn eyes and skin. Therefore, when operating, you must use the special dimming screen and black shading sheet that are randomly distributed. Before officially starting work, you need to check the foot switch to detect whether the dimming screen automatically turns black and opaque. The electrode adopts cerium tungsten electrode. Generally, there are a small amount of defects in the corners and the plane, and the direct 1.6 mm electrode is used. When the amount of repair is large and the welding current is also large, electrodes with a diameter of 2.4 mm can be used. When welding flat or protruding edges and corners, the end of the object can be ground into a cone of about 70-90 degrees, which is more stable when welding. But when welding internal angles or relatively narrow gaps, you need to grind the black needles to 20-30 degrees. The sharp cones on the left and right are better. When welding copper, aluminum and other metals, the black needle can be ground into a hemispherical shape. In general, it is best that the length of the black needle exposed to the ceramic mouth is about 35 mm. If the exposure is too long, it is easy to cause the argon gas to not concentrate, making the solder joints yellow or black. If the exposure is too short, the site of the operation will be poor. This is the composition, operation and other matters of the cold welding machine I shared with you today. If you want to know more about cold welding machine knowledge, we will see you in the next issue.